मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी ऑल आर हियर फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग अबाउट द लैंग्वेज. देर आर मैनी इल्यूजन्स, देर आर मैनी मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग्स in the different concept of English language. What is dialect? What is accent? What is style? There are different views behind these terms of English language, and even proficient speakers of English are unable to speak English well. Lack of accent due to some sort of misunderstandings and illusions in language, they cannot represent well in English. So there are the three things that influence it. One is pronunciation, second is vocabulary, and third is grammar. If one variety of the language differs from each other in all three, means pronunciation, vocabulary, and grammar, if one variety of the language differs from each other in all three ways, we call it dialect. But most commonly it is the first way, that is pronunciation, which makes the difference, means which marks the difference and is called an accent. What is an accent? Way of speaking? Is it style of speaking? No, it is entirely different. Accent is the most visible characteristic of any language. Most visible characteristic. We can quite early distinguish an American speaker from the British. There is the difference of speaking in the American and British, not only in speaking but also in writing. Written and spoken, both the concepts are different. On what basis? Also on the basis of accent. Bernard Shaw, when placed in the committee of educated person where speech is correct and refined, said that even on their committee there were different accents. He said the simplest and the commonest words in any language are yes and no. But two members of the committee pronounced them exactly alike. There is no doubt that two people do not speak in a similar manner. After all, we are not same. Machines produced in a factory. The difference in speech actually reflects difference in individuality. But still we have this desire to be understood by everyone and understand every one. So Bernard Shaw further says, every member pronounces them in such a way that they would not only be intelligible, they would not only be intelligible in every English speaking country, but would stamp the speaker as a cultivated way one must understand the concept of standard English, and so as to be able to choose the correct mode of speech to flow. But before that, we must get into one more idea. We know what an accent is and what a dialect is. There is something else which also marks of difference between the varieties is of the language. The style of language or the choice of words. Look at the following three sentences. I'm faked out. Second one is, I'm very tired. I'm very tired. Third is, I am exhausted. Meaning based, these words are the same, but these words are being pronounced differently on the basis of pronunciation. So pronunciation is the third greatest concept of the language, which is basically required to improve in our fundamentals. All the three sentences have similar meaning, but they use different words. The first one uses informal expression. Many people might not have the idea for the word fag, which is a colloquial British expression. The second sentence uses formal enjoy. Words to be accepted by everyone, but at the same time informal enough to be used by even a child. Even a child, yes. While the third sentence uses the expression which formal enough to be known by a child. The choice of word depends on a scenario in which the words are to be used. Students are understanding carefully and listening carefully. Concentration. It needs great concentration. Let us see what Shaw has to say about this. I am at present speaking to the audience of many thousands. If I were to speak to you as carelessly as I speak to my wife at home, this record would be useless. And if I were to speak to my wife at home as carefully as I am speaking to you, she would think I was going mad. What is a neutral accent? So today we are studying accents of the language. There is not a single correct accent of English. All speakers of English need to copy with many different aspects and learn how to understand them. Some accents are associated with social group who have high prestige, but there are also many of these high prestige accents. All of them regionally based. The accents that are traditionally taught to non-native speakers of English are high prestige accents from various places. Various places. So, time, place and action. These three factors are influencing the accent. How these three factors are more important in understanding sentence, word and accent of the language. The two most commonly taught accents are both rather artificial. General American means more or less a Midwestern and West Coast accent and used by some high prestige speaker outside this. And the British accents means RP, received pronunciation, which developed in the private boarding school of the 19th century and is associated with high prestige groups in England. Both these accents are used over a wide geographical area. Though in word terms, both are regional accents, General American is used as General American is an General American is a different accent and RP is an accent of England. They are heard more by more people in the country than are accents which are associated with a small area. So people are familiar with them. These accents are the ones transcribed in dictionaries because they are used over wide areas. Yes. Now you are understanding difference between American and British accent and used by people of high social clan. They are seen as being sociable to each, to foreign learners of England or English. For this reason, they are called reference varieties. When radio was developed in the country, 20th century, many radio stations in the US and the UK reflected their continuity, presentation and news readers by their accent. So General American is sometimes known as Network English and RP is sometimes known as BBC English. The effect to these policies of course was to add when further to prestige of the reference accents and to increase the population's exposure to them. The BBC incidentally no longer has this policy and now uses news readers and presented with a wide range of accents. So your understanding about their accent, about the accent of the BBC London. In all languages, some accents have higher prestige than others. Test of judgment have been mod in many language, which show that people within a community often share judgment have been met. In the UK, for example, the accents associated with the city of Birmingham consistently comes out being ugliest, while London accents tend to be heard as criminal. Their judgment are based on stereotyping or stereotypical association. If British accents are played to Americans, they do not make the same judgment because they have not learned to associate different British accents with the same stereotype. British people have. In the US, in the US, many speakers are prejudiced against southern accents. But British people would not judge southern accents badly in the same way. Judgments like this are not based on anything in the accents itself. If different accents of English are played to recessions who speak no English, they cannot distinguish the high prestige from the low prestige accents. One should try to speak neutrally about different accents and not suggest that one accent is better than another. The reference varieties are not standard accents, because no one is required to use them. Compare this to spelling. We are expected to use the standard spelling and to our best to correct mistakes. The influence varieties, reference varieties are not more careful or more correct than other accents. It is just an accident of history that their speakers were the ones with power. Yes, next is chord mixing and chord switching. Chord mixing and chord switching refers to the mixing of two or more language varieties in speech. Same scholar used the terms chord mixing and chord switching interchangeably, especially in studies of syntax, morphology and other formal aspects of language. Others assume more specific definitions of chord fixing, chord mixing, but these specific definitions may be different in different subfield of linguistics, education theory, communication, etc. Chord mixing is similar to the use or creation of pidgins. But while a pidgin is created across groups that do not share a common language, chord mixing may occur within a multilingual setting where speakers share more than one language. Chord mixing switching is the concurrent use of more than one language or language variety in conversations. Multilinguals, people who speak more than one language, sometimes use elements of multiple languages in conversing with each other. Thus, chord switching is the use of more linguistic varieties in a manner consistent with the syntax and phonology of each variety. Chord switching is distinct from other language contact phenomena such as borrowing, pidgins and creoles. Land translation and languages transfer. Speakers from and establish a pidgin languages when two or more speakers who do not speak a common language for an intermediate third language. On the other hand, speaker practice chord switching when they are each fluent in both languages. Chord mixing is a thematically violated term, but the usage of the terms chord switching and chord mixing varieties. Some scholarly use either term to denote the same practice, while others apply chord mixing to denote the formal linguistic properties of said language. Contact phenomena and chord switching to denote the actual speaker usage by multilingual persons. In the 1940s and 1950s, many scholars called chord switching a substandard language usage. Since the 1980s, however, most scholars have recognized it is a normal, neutral natural product of bilingual and multilingual languages use. The term code switching is also used outside the field. Yes, it is all about the code mixing and code switching. Thank you.